It's been 18 years since we last saw Keanu Reeves playing Neo. Hello everyone, I'm Zach and welcome back to another HitFilm tutorial. Today we'll be creating this streaming code effect inspired by the trailer for the new Matrix film. The project files for this effect are linked in the video description, so feel free to download them and follow along. This video footage was filmed outside at night to match the shot in the Matrix trailer. If you are shooting your own footage, I would recommend not showing the sky or any very bright area in the clip. The code effect looks best when applied to a dark scene. Another thing to keep in mind is the geometry of the scene. Our footage is pretty simple with flat walls and a road, and it's easier to add the code animation to flat surfaces. I'd also recommend keeping the camera locked off on a tripod to avoid any motion tracking. And if you have an actor in your shot, place a green screen behind them to avoid any rotoscoping. With the footage brought into HitFilm, I added some color grading to make it darker and a little more blue to look like nighttime. If you want to learn more about how to film and edit dark scenes, check out the video linked in the card on screen. The streams of numbers were created using HitFilm's Particle Simulator. This rendered animation is included for free in the downloadable project file, so you can enter the matrix without having to calculate this heavy simulation. To create this animation, I started with a default particle sim. I set the shape to quad and the trajectory to cone, and adjusted the settings to make the particles fall down from above frame. I removed the default particle system and instead added a mobile emitter. This allowed each particle to emit its own particles, resulting in this trail effect. The particle simulator comes with a built-in texture of numbers, which works perfectly for this kind of effect. I then adjusted the scale, speed, particles per second, and life of the mobile emitter and its particle system to dial in the movement and shape of the trails. The mobile emitter color was set to white and the trail particles were set to green. I also added a gradient to their alpha in the lifetime panel to make them quickly fade in and slowly fade out. To make the particles farther away from the camera darker than those closer to the camera, I adjusted the fog settings and the composite shot properties. A stutter effect was applied to make the animation less smooth. I then duplicated the particle sim, changed the seed to create a different pattern, and shifted it on the timeline by a couple frames. This filled in the frame with more particles that moved at a slightly different time. Finally, I rendered this animation as a video file so I could work with it much faster, and you can find it in the downloadable project files. Now that we have our simulation rendered as a video file, we can bring it back into HitFilm to place it in our scene. Drag the video onto the timeline and make it a 3D plane. Reduce the opacity so you can see through it. Then adjust the layer's rotation, position, and scale to line it up with the floor in the footage. Once it's lined up, duplicate the layer and move it to cover the remaining floor. There will be a harsh line where the layer ends and the code graphic is cut off. To smooth it out, double-click the rectangle mask tool to add a mask that covers the whole layer. Then in the mask properties, set the feather to in and increase it. Now this layer fades in at the edges. I'll duplicate this layer one more time to finish covering the floor. Now we need more copies of the code video to cover the walls. Duplicate the original code layer and adjust its rotation and position to line up with one of the walls. I won't adjust the scale so the size of the numbers will be consistent. You can hide the floor layers for now if they're in the way. You can also go into other 3D views like top view to make sure the walls are lined up with the floor. Repeat the process of duplicating and adjusting to cover the walls. We don't really need the feathered mask for the walls since the edges are vertical and any cutting off of the graphic won't be noticeable. I'll place one final duplicate to cover the sky and distant background. Make the layer 2D and place it below the other layers. Scale it to cover the remaining areas. Then use a tile effect to repeat the pattern and make the numbers the right size. Shift each code layer on the timeline by a different amount so they aren't all the exact same pattern at the same time. Select all of the floor layers and make them into their own comp. Now we can use the freehand mask tool to draw a shape on the entire floor, so it only appears where the floor appears in our video. Also make the walls into their own comp and mask it so the walls don't cover the sky. If you see any gaps after masking, you can adjust the placement. Make all of these code layers into one more composite shot. This leaves us with one layer in the main comp that contains all the code graphics, making it much easier to apply effects to the entire animation. I'll set the layer's blend mode to add, then I'll apply some glow effects to boost its brightness. With our code effect created, we can now add some final details to finish off the shot. Add a new black plane layer, placing it above the video footage but below the code comp. Reduce its opacity by 5 or 10% so you can barely see through it. In the Matrix trailer, this darkening effect has a rectangular section cut out of the middle. Draw a rectangle mask that covers the entire plane. Now duplicate the mask, set it to subtract, and scale it down. The code effect is currently going over top of the person walking. This means we will have to rotoscope the person to cut them out and place them back over top. You can create a rough mask and feather it out to save time, but the result will look better with more accurate masking. For my final shot, I used Mocha HitFilm to greatly speed up the masking process, so be sure to check out the tutorial linked in the card on screen to learn more about rotoscoping with Mocha. Let's create a green outline effect on our video footage. Duplicate the footage layer and apply a fined edges effect. You can fine-tune the result by adding additional effects before the fined edges, such as a curves effect to adjust the brightness, and a blur effect to smooth it out a little. Make the image black and white by applying a hue saturation effect and reducing the saturation. Then make it green using a tint effect. Change the white color to be green and increase the amount. Set this layer's blend mode to add. I don't want an outline around the person walking in the shot, so I'll add a feathered mask around that area. I'll also add a curves effect before the tint to enhance the line some more. At the moment, the shot is quite static, so let's add some subtle camera movement. Add a new point layer and parent all the other layers to it. Our image doesn't cover the whole frame anymore, so increase the scale on the point. Now we can animate the point's position to create the camera movement. I'll adjust the middle keyframe's control handles to create a smoother movement. The animation is a little too perfect, so let's add a new grade layer and apply a shake effect. The default settings are way too much, so let's reduce the settings to make the movement more natural. And that's how you can create your own Matrix code VFX. Be sure to check out our other Matrix-inspired tutorials. Hit the like button if you learned something new, and subscribe for more HitFilm tutorials. See you next time!